here we are. It's, what time is it? 9:02. Can you see that? Yeah, you can see it. That's 9:02. Why does it say backward 6 OS?
Maybe we should do it this way. Let's see. Interesting.
Hey, wait, what is today? Wednesday, 11/4. We're, all of us kitties are here in bed, except for Boob. We got a pee-pee right here.
Is he happy, pee? Hi, man. Oh, I'm here, man. I'm all right. I'm good, man. I'm good. Purring. He's purring now. He's getting some attention. He's purring. Hi, bud.
We got June decided to join us tonight. He's over his hurt feelings of being left for 5 days. And we got Tiny right here. She's just kicking.
Doing it, Tiny.
Wow, look at that. Especially how it reflects off the white. So that's what it is. See that? You put anything white in front of the camera and it automatically develops a light. That's Junior's body right there. So, look at that. See, an automatic light, man. And it always flashes on and off. It's wild. So, we just got to make sure we put it in front. There it is. See? In front of the lens. The camera lens. Look at that. Wow. That's cool, man. That's a natural law somehow, the way it does that. There it is. There it is. Gotta get it just right. There it went. There. That's cool. We're all just kicking here. I've been reading some books. Rereading some books. Parts of books. I'm learning to, when I first open up the book and I just start reading, I'm learning that it has a special message wrapped up in the words that is very fundamental to the moment. And also in describing stuff that I've gone through throughout the day. It's wild. Little purple light right here. There it is. So we can even do it we can put, because there's white right there. So supposedly it should, there, make it some type of, I see two little tiny purple dots on the lens of the iPod. It's almost like the two dots of a happy face. And they're at an angle, like 10 o'clock to 4 o'clock. Anyway, I was reading, I opened up the book to The Vision by W.B. Yeats. I've been studying that book now for a year. I think last summer I started in on it, but I decided in my mind that was a very important book to conquer, and it, like I said, one of my videos, it's going to take me about 4 times reading this book to understand it, but I'm just in the mood right now just to read little parts here and there. I get a notion that I need to read from the book. I can just feel it. My body's ready. There's a message to be had. It's just a knowing, man. It's
just something that's developed. But, you know, just like a mother knows when she needs to tend to her child, it's just an automatic knowing. But I was reading about the phase 19, and talking about the American visionary, and started going in on the use of the false mask and the imagination to bring into existence the most creative force in the body. And it talks about going into a deep imaginary world, man, to the point to where we want that imaginary world to become real. And that's what I've been doing here lately. I've been really, you know, doing my radio program, just talking to myself just constantly, as though it's second nature, with no fear. And using the power of my thoughts that everything I say in the will be acceptable to any ears that might hear it in the neighbors or the public access bike path behind my house. And there we are. Flight deck control right there now. Ready room. The red lights. And then I opened up the George W. Carey's book in combination with Inez Eudora Perry. She's the one who actually wrote the most of the book, but she includes some of the George Carey writings in the beginning of the book. And then she expands upon it. You know, just like through history, you know, everybody always adds to the previous writer. It's the evolution of knowledge, you know. But we got us a little crystal looking thing. It's like a globe or a sphere, transparent sphere with a crystal in the middle of it.
Attention, Jim. Turn me a turd. Oh.
He was alerted by the.
Did it alert you? Yeah, there's. Where's that noise come from? Are you having a fear flinch or is it a pure curiosity?
It's hard to tell. Was that a fear flinch or pure curiosity? But I've been doing a study on cats and watching how they have fear flinches. It's just the same as human beings, you know. But we were made to be able to overcome those fear flinches. But anyway, so I'm reading, opened up the Zodiac book and astrology. It's called Zodiacs and the Salts of Salvation. And I opened up the book to Cancer. It was Cancer is a calcium fluoride salt, representative of, but it was talking about Mother Isis and the spleen. Corpuscles are formed by Mother Isis in the spleen. And I looked at that word spleen and I noticed, oh my God, S-P-leen, L-E-E-N. And I thought to myself, oh my God, there's some secret correlation between the commercial liens that we write up and post in the public record for the corporation to see. You know, any public record's good public record. Even if you tattoo it on your forehead. and tell the pursuing pirate to read your forehead. And any record's good public record, man. Remember, we are the creators of our environment. But you know, moving on with the story, or the information. The lean, man, there's some correlation between the spleen, which is a body organ, where corpuscles are formed, supposedly. Now, this is just some man's story telling us about this. But he's, you know, she, Inez Udera Perry, is a female. And she's found through her own private studies of the astrological stars and their locations and relations to each other that the outer space is showing us that the spleen is the place where new cells are born, corpuscles. And that has to do with the zodiac sign called Cancer. Ingwe Malmsteen is a Cancer sign. And Cancer is a water sign, and so is Scorpio. Scorpio is a water sign. Scorpio is my my birth mother's sign. But she leans more toward the date of Libra. But Scorpios are very intense people. Very intense. And and they are very diligent to get to the bottom of things. Very intently. And anyway. Which reminds me, I saw the Michael Shankner and Matthias Jabs in the latest Guitar magazine, which featured David Gilmour on the cover, which with a quote saying, "The King has returned." And and you know, they had the article in there about Scorpions as well as other bands and stuff like that. One of the other bands I need to start giving attention to is Crocus. I was big on Crocus when I was growing up. And I was big on all the bands, but Crocus was one of them included. But I don't give Crocus a lot of attention, but that just came to my mind. I'm going to go on YouTube and I'm going to start checking out Crocus and giving them a bunch of attention. And because they were very impacting in my life as far as music goes. And, but, you know, getting back to the quotation in the book, it says, you know, Mother Isis, corpuscles are formed by Mother Isis in the spleen. So I thought to myself, oh my God, lean, spleen, there's a correlation here. All right? There's a correlation to meditate on. And I thought about the signs of Mother Nature in synchronization with thought, which is tied right into the no collection security agreement and the commercial lien. Because once we acquire that position in life, then the universe is able to take us to the next level of learning, which has everything to do with eternal life and the reforming of brand new cells in our bodies to be able to make them live forever. So the spleen, the lean, but anyway, we're at 15 minutes, so we'll talk to you later on this one. So talk to you later. And that was on page, let's see right here,
I'll just put it right here. But we got to go. Talk to you later. 15.